Good morning. Our lesson for today is about multiplying fractions. We have three objectives. The first one is to multiply two fractions. The second, to multiply a fraction by a whole number. And the third one is to evaluate expressions. Let us start with the first objective. Three simple steps are required to multiply two fractions. Step one, multiply the numerators by each other. And remember that the numerators are the numbers that are on the top. So if I want to make 2 over 5 times 3 over 4, I have to start multiplying 2 times 3, 6. Step 2, multiply the denominators. It's not like the addition and subtraction. In addition and subtraction, I keep the denominators the same. While in multiplication, I have to multiply the denominators. So here, 4 times 5 is 20. But this is not the final answer, because I have to go to the third step, which is to simplify and reduce the answer. If the answer is an improper fraction, I have to make it a mixed number. In all the cases, if it's a proper or improper fraction, I have to check if I can reduce it or simplify it by dividing the numerator and denominator by the same number. Here both the 6 and the 20 are divisible by 2, so the final answer of 2 over 5 times 3 over 4 is 3 over 10. The second objective, to multiply a fraction by a whole number. Actually, I have to go exactly through the same steps, except for one extra step in the beginning. There is a common mistake that most of the students, they do it. I will show you what's the common mistake, then I will show you what is the correct way to do. If I want to make 3 over 4 times 5, some students, they might do this mistake. They might multiply both numerator and denominator by the number 5. So they make it 3 times 5, 15, 4 times 5, 20, which is wrong answer. Instead of this, you have to write the 5 as a whole number. You make it 5 over 1. And then you follow exactly the same steps that we did in the previous example. You make 3 times 5, 15, 4 times 1, 4. 15 over 4 is an improper fraction, so I have to make it a mixed number. 15 divided by 4 is a 3. 3 times 4 is 12, so what is left to make it 15? It's a 3 over 4. The fraction part, which is a 3 over 4, is already simplified, reduced, so I cannot simplify anymore. The final answer of 3 over 4 times 5 is a 3 and 3 quarters. To change the fraction into a mixed number, since it's allowed for you to use calculators, simply insert the fraction 15 over 4 in the calculator. Press equal, then press shift and the key S to D. You will find that it will turn to a mixed number. Third objective, to evaluate expressions. To evaluate an algebraic expression, you have to substitute a number for each variable and perform the arithmetic operations. Example, x equals 2 over 3 and y equals 5 over 7. Work out the value of xy. Xy means x times y, so I have to substitute x by 2 over 3 times y, which is 5 over 7. Then I have to perform the arithmetic operation, which means I have to follow the same rule of multiplying fractions. So multiply the numerators, 2 times 5 is 10. Multiply the denominators, 3 times 7, 21. Make sure that the answer is simplified and reduced, which means it is a proper fraction, otherwise I have to make it a mixed number, and I cannot simplify by dividing numerator and denominator by the same number. So the final answer of xy is 10 over 21. Part B, yx. I have to substitute first y, then times x. Y is 5 over 7 times 2 over 3. 5 times 2 is 10. 7 over 3, 7 times 3 is 21. I get the same answer. Because as you know, in multiplication, if you say x times y or y times x, you are going to get the same answer, which is the commutative property. Part C, x squared. X squared means the number by itself, multiplied by itself. First step, I want to substitute. When you substitute, you have to put a bracket and the square is outside, because the square is for both the numerator and the denominator. After that, you can do one of two things. Either you put the 2 squared over the 3 squared and you will solve each one separately. Or you write it 2 over 3 times 2 over 3. So you repeat multiplying it twice by itself. In the two cases, you are going to get the same answer. 2 squared is the same like 2 over 2. Sorry, it's the same like 2 times 2, which is 4. 3 squared is the same like 3 times 3, which is 9. The answer is already simplified and reduced, so no need to do anything after that. Part D, y squared. So I have to substitute y by 5 over 7 exactly in the same way. Don't forget the brackets to show that the square is for both numerator and denominator. 5 squared over 7 squared, or 5 over 7 times 5 over 7. 5 squared, which is 5 times 5, it gives you 25. 7 squared, which is 7 times 7, it gives you 49. The answer is simplified and reduced. The last example I'm going to solve it with you today is half plus quarter between brackets times 3 over 4, over 5. According to order of operations, I have to start solving with what's inside the brackets. So I have to start ignoring the times 3 over 5, solve half plus quarter. Remember, in addition, I must have the same denominator. 2 and 4, the common denominator for them is 4, which is the LCM. So the first fraction, I have to multiply both the numerator and denominator by 2. It becomes 2 over 4. Just give the second fraction the same. Now, because I have like denominators, I can add the numerators. 2 plus 1 is 3. It stays over 4. In addition and in subtraction, I don't change the denominator. Now, I'm done with the first part, simplifying what's inside the bracket. I have to copy times 5 over 3. It becomes like normal multiplication. All what do I have to do is to multiply numerators by each other. 3 times 3 is 9. Denominators by each other, 4 times 5, 20. Make sure that the answer is simplified. It is a proper fraction. Reduced, which means I cannot divide the numerator and denominator by the same number. And that's the final answer. Just for your information, to simplify a fraction, since it's allowed to use calculator again, just simply insert the fraction that you want in the calculator, press equal and check if you will get the same fraction or it is simplified. That will help you to know if you can simplify it or not. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.